Hi, my name is Grace, and I'm from Boston, Massachusetts.
Hi, my name is Giselle, and I'm from Jackson, Mississippi. And today, we're going to answer a couple of questions about what we like about USD in San Diego. All right, so just get started with the first one. Okay, this is a good one. What are some restaurants in San Diego that remind you of home?
Cool. I don't know. This is a hard one. I don't know. There's not a lot of local Boston foods. But, you know, clam chowder maybe. But I would say there are a lot of restaurants that make this feel like home, you know, that, you know, P.F. Chang's is everywhere. That's here. But then there's like some local eateries like Cafe Coyote in downtown or no, in Old Town. And then Sfico 1845 in Little Italy, which is like bomb Italian food. And so that's just like good food that you can, you know, really connect with.
For me, I would say, like, being from Mississippi, there's actually, I found a place, did a little bit of research. There's a place called Bankhead Mississippi Style Cooking, and the people there are actually from Mississippi, and it's like maybe 2 hours from where I live. So I go there, and they have like these Mississippi artists playing on like the sound system, and all the food just reminds me of home. So it's always a good time when I go there. I'd say that always reminds me of home. Yeah, all right, so let's move on to the next question here. Name a food that's totally San Diego. I don't know, but for me, California burrito always comes to mind. It's like this giant, massive burrito stuffed with like french fries and sour cream and guacamole and carne asada. But I think you can put like other stuff in it, like adobo, which is like fried pork or like...
Like chicken, you can get
some
shredded chicken.
Always go with the chicken or shrimp if you're feeling fancy for the day. And then, it's like just really good. I'll usually split mine in half, have one for like lunch and one for dinner. You know, trying to think ahead. Yeah. What about you?
I would say baked bear. I think baked bear is a pretty good San Diego food. It's like, you know, you take two cookies that you get to decide on. My favorite is like the chocolate chip with the mint chip in the middle.
Okay,
I've had people do like the s'more cookie with...
I like the red velvet one.
Oh, with the red velvet and then shove any ice cream you want in the middle.
That's the best. With the cookies and cream ice cream.
That's a go-to beach food.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's a good one. It's in Mission Beach too, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, gotta go. All right, let's see. The next one is, what was one way you handled homesickness?
Oh, that's a really good question.
Yeah.
So I actually went to a boarding school before coming to USD.
Oh, really?
And so, yeah. And so I've lived away for quite some time. I consider myself an expert. No, I'm just kidding. But I was able to, you know, I've dealt with homesickness in different ways, but the one that worked for me the best was when I just kind of accepted it for myself. And I was like, all right, Grace, you might be homesick. Your parents are far away, but, you know, the opportunities are here for you.
Yeah.
So, you know, you just got to work through it. You know, call mom and dad here and there. You know, look
always
at pictures of your house or call your friends. Or just find people who also feel homesick, you know, and just connect with them. And they'll say it's okay and you'll say it's okay and you'll be okay. It might, you know, stink at points, but... homesickness is natural when you're like becoming independent. So
I know, especially like if you can find, like you were saying, like find someone here who's also from where you're from and they connect on like certain things. That's like the best thing ever. Cause like you understand what I'm missing. Like, I don't know, for me, whenever I run somebody like who's from the South, especially like we have like a lot of Texas students here. I was like, man, I really wish there was somewhere I could get some good sweet tea. And they were like, I know. And then and then we like come together and we're like, we'll just go to McDonald's and get that sweet tea. That's the best thing we got.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm from the South, so like cooking is a big thing. So I just learned like my family's recipes and then I cook their recipes and that makes me feel like I'm at home.
That's nice. So going to your house, geez.
I know, right? I know. Okay, what's the biggest culture shock you've encountered after arriving to USD?
So for me, it was definitely how like nice people are, like random people, strangers, how nice strangers are.
Yeah, 'cause you're from the East Coast, right?
Yeah, I'm from the Northeast, and there, you know, people are very much about, you know, walking down the sidewalk, doing what they have to do. They don't really look or smile at you or converse with you. And here, everyone's like, hey, how are you? You know, how are you? Look
I
in
think
your
it's
eyes.
Definitely like
smile.
The weather and the view that makes that happen.
You can't
go
wrong here.
How
so
could you
I
be mad looking at that like every
you
day,
can't
right?
You can't be wrong.
I don't know, like the biggest thing for me was the interstates, just the way they are here.
Yeah.
I don't know, it's kind of like, it was a little scary at first because like in Jackson, we have like one freeway, one interstate, and it's pretty much never crowded or like traffic jam. But here's like, you have to get used to like coming up and getting the traffic. But I mean, once you get a hold of it, you'll drive it like a pro.
Yeah.
All right, let's see. And I think that's, wow, that's all the questions we have. Awesome. So thank you guys for watching, and I guess we'll catch you guys in the fall, right?
Yeah, we can't wait to see you and welcome you to our campus.
All right, see you guys later.